Back at it again. I am in Botswana, Okavango Delta, one of the most remote, pristine, and untouched locations in the world. What am I doing here? I'm here on a special assignment with African Conservation Experience to document important conservation work that their organization is doing in this area to protect remaining wildlife. We all anticipated this project for over 2 years. Now I am here and I'm very excited to join the team of volunteers and researchers on the mission to collect data that helps to establish threats to this very fragile ecosystem and wildlife. Watch this video till the end to see me survive and thrive in African bush, learn how to monitor and track animals for research, interview scientists and locals, and of course, as always, try having as much fun as possible while connecting to nature! The Okavango Delta is home to some of the world's most endangered species of large mammals, counting a total of 130 species. During flooding between June and September, this area becomes an important water source for animals living in the dry areas of the surrounding Kalahari Desert. This area is incredibly significant. It supports plant and animal species and provides refuge during adverse conditions. We're here on a mission to raise awareness about ecological and conservation problems that Southern Africa is experiencing and to offer insights and solutions to those problems, as well as to promote responsible volunteerism that lets people and tourists see behind the scenes of very important conservation work that is happening here and offers an opportunity to help both physically and financially. Although it looks like the Garden of Eden, the wet delta poses many challenges to animals, including making it difficult to move from place to place, leading to this area's becoming overgrazed, as well as poaching, pollution, and do we even have to mention climate change? The aim of this project is to monitor changes in animal populations over time to see how they are affected by human activities, which is critical information for the long-term sustainability of the Okavango Delta. This project is therefore helping to protect and understand one of the largest intact ecosystems remaining in Africa. The data collected is shared with the Botswana Department of Wildlife and National Parks, who use it to make management and policy decisions.
We end up going into a period where there's going to be huge changes, and those changes are going to impact the lives of people, it's going to impact wildlife populations, and it's going to impact livestock. And with climate change and the change in water availability, it's going to create a lot of competition for humans, for livestock and for wildlife to share the water resource.
Is it too late?
I don't know how, to what extent we can slow down the rate of change, but the impacts in Southern Africa will be massive.
This is the only project in the area that does such needed and important research, as well as runs volunteer project that lets passionate nature lovers from all over the world experience life in the bush, learn the basics of research and collecting data, and offer local team much needed physical and financial support. Okay, so we were out for about 20 minutes this morning and we are exploring the ground by foot and we're taking notes of all the tracks that we find. So far, in just under 20 minutes, we discovered prints of two wild dogs, wild cat, a leopard, and a cheetah. Isn't that incredible?
Living with wildlife comes with a very high cost. People living in a different environment wants to dictate to the people living on the ground with these animals how they should live with them without realizing what are the practical issues of daily living with these animals. People living with elephants have the price that it's dangerous, your children can't walk to school. 90% of the conflict with lions happens within 15 kilometers from the edge of the conservation areas, meaning that very few lions get beyond 15 kilometers away from the conservation area before they kill. It's definitely not animals versus people. in this last 50 years. People learned a lot about how to deal with the conflict and make it better and easier for people and wildlife to live together. That is the key for long-term conservation, is resolving human-wildlife conflict.
We just found Kuru's horn. Pretty impressive, look how twisted it is. Killed by the lions. This research is fully funded by the volunteer project, and with their contribution, the project is able to provide salaries to staff and ecologists, vehicles and fuel. Volunteers help with the research directly. You start your day with beautifully brightly red sunrise, quick tea or coffee, some snacks, and the team hops on the open safari car. Do you think you have the guts to experience life in the bush, to get fully disconnected from the outside world and get fully immersed into animals, into nature, research, and life in the bush? Let me know in the comments if you think you'd be up for this challenge.
Try to empower people to know how they can benefit living together with livestock, the resources that they have in their area. The importance of living together with the nature. To generate employment or to create, make a good platform without killing animals, to come with an idea that can empower local people. But, you know, it's very, very hard for someone like SK to understand or to believe to live with a wild animal. That offense is one that separates movement of livestock. Our domestic animal and wild animal not to come together. But elephant, because they are giant of the land, elephants, they are very naughty. They break the fence.
Yeah, it didn't look like it would keep an elephant out.
Because this fence is over 2,000 kilometers. Over 2,000 kilometers.
That's a long fence.
It's a long fence. For a developing country like Botswana, it's difficult.
The team is responsible for covering 25 designated areas of land or transects, which are done daily on rotation. The team provides extra eyes for spotting animals, which helps to maximize accuracy for far more detailed and correct findings. Volunteers also input the data into the tablet so the guide can fully focus on driving those very challenging routes. Everyone is responsible for watching out for animals, but there are also two special roles, such as using a rangefinder to establish the distance and inputting the data into the cyber tracker app.
Okay, so this is a moment of real science. We came to the stop and we have two scientists in front of us. We found a group of three warthogs.
What's the distance?
And a group of six.
What was the distance again?
And we're using this gadget that is called a rangefinder, which is helping us to establish the distance between the vehicle and the animals. And all this data is going straight over there in this little iPad.
Okay, so this morning I am on a data capturing duty. We just spotted this giraffe, so now I'm gonna enter the data. We're collecting information such as sex, type of species, distance on the road, distance from the vehicle to the animal, what else, the type of the environment that we're around. So this is dense woodland, and all this information will then help us to protect those species. Data captured.
What's making northern Botswana special is we have high densities of herbivores and we have areas with low densities. So we have areas where lions and hyenas are dominant with a high density of prey available, but we also have areas where they are low density, which is good for your subordinate carnivores, cheetahs and wild dogs, that they can use as refuge areas away from these carnivores that will dominate them. Northern Botswana, roughly between 130,000 and 140,000 elephants.
Mm-hmm. and comparing that to other countries?
Botswana has more than all the rest of the countries put together.
Uh-huh. Why is that the case?
Large conservation area and effective conservation. What is important is biodiversity, which includes the herbivores and the carnivores, and the way that the different carnivores interact with the herbivores, and the different ways that the herbivores interact with the vegetation. That's all part of biodiversity, and that's what we need to conserve.
After working and volunteering with animals for over 10 years, this project is a different level of heart. It is a real challenge for the overactive mind like mine, a real test for your focus and concentration, and a real experiment on how present you can be. You have to be constantly observant and alert, having your eyes always peeled, looking out for the movement in the bushes. And you have been running this project for 11 years?
Yes, since 2011.
So this data that we're collecting, who has access to it?
We make reports out of it and we send that to the Department of Wildlife and National Parks. So they have full access to that data.
And till this day, how has this data been used and for what?
First of all, it's part of, they require the concession holders to do some basic monitoring. So we're doing it for that purpose, but also to have a conservation value. The same way it contributes to the other species assessments, filling in some of the gaps on line densities and distribution. This data has been used to assess tourism potential of different parts in Botswana, helping authorities to plan tourism development.
And what are your future plans for this project?
First of all, is to maintain the monitoring that we're doing, because the longer your data set, the more valuable it becomes in understanding ecological fluctuations and also if there's any disturbance factors coming into the system. And we're looking at giving more attention to the giraffes specifically, given that they are considered endangered across Africa, and this area we know we have a good giraffe population.
While of course we're here doing important research on wildlife, it is also you that you get to research. Who are you? Why are you here? What is your part of this, of nature? Where do you stand on important topics like poaching, hunting, freedom of animals, conservation, tourism? You might be struck with the reality of what some local people think on those topics, but it really helps you to see the perspective, to understand that every story and every problem has at least two sides, if not more. In the next videos, we will be exploring more about those topics and other things that I learned during my time participating in this conservation project. So please support this video with your comments and likes, and please subscribe to my channel because we have a lot of exciting environmental and conservation content coming out just for you. I want to remind you that this video is the first video of our bigger and wider conservation initiative with African Conservation Experience. This is it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end. Your support means everything to us, and I really hope that you learned something new from this video. Thank you, and I see you next week. Bye! Stick it into my glasses. That's how we do it in the bush.